is giving us the message, so come on up, Chuck.
Pray with me. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful. Kindle in us the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and we shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit instructs the hearts of the faithful, grant that by that same Holy Spirit we may be truly wise and ever rejoice in his consolation. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The title of my message tonight is, Can I Really Know God? In Psalm 19, 1 and 2, the Bible says, The heavens are telling the glory of God. They are a marvelous display of his craftsmanship. Day and night, they keep telling about God. So where do I begin to try to know him? Read about him in the Bible. I can hear about him in sermons. I can know him through personal encounters with him. Last week, my brother in Christ, Rene Lopez, talked about his personal encounter with God. I can know his heart through the sacrifice of Jesus Christ. I can see what he created. He formed a rose. He formed the rose whose petals are made with care and precision, and the cactus with long, sharp needles. The smell of the rose is sweet, and the needles of the cactus can be very painful. He created both. So what was he thinking? I believe we can know through the power of the Holy Spirit what God did first in creation, and then in us. But how do I comprehend God? God asked Job, where were you when I created the foundation of the earth? That's a pretty intimidating statement for me, but I still want to know God. What do I do? I need to go back to his word. God says he will never leave me or forsake me. Forsake me, what does that mean? He will never turn away, he will never reject me. God loves me. Reaches out to all those he created. This is the God I want to know. In the book Emotionally Healthy Spirituality, Peter Scazzaro speaks about our feelings. Feelings? Really? Feelings? How can I trust my feelings? When Linda and I go to North Carolina, we love to hike in the mountains. And when we start on a path, it may take us across meadows, maybe through small streams, across rough terrains. And there will be trees surrounding us as we make our way to the top for a breathtaking view. We can see for miles and miles how beautiful seeing the valley below, the rolling hills, the rivers slowly winding and then changing into crashing waterfalls. What a feeling of joy and accomplishment. But as we descend back to the trailhead, sweaty, tired, my feeling of accomplishment fades. I see many dangerous drop-offs that I didn't notice before. I'm not sure this was such a good idea to take this hike. It's feelings. My feelings are fickle. They're constantly changing. Is that the way I understand God? The author says, God created us to feel a wide range of emotions, literally hundreds of them. Some of the main ones are anger, sadness, fear, enjoyment, love. Jeremiah 30:24 says, the fierce anger of the Lord will not turn back until he fully accomplishes the purpose of his heart. Let's say that was anger. Genesis 1:25. And God was pleased by what he had done. Enjoyment. Jeremiah 31:3. I have loved you with an everlasting love. This is the emotion of love. If God has those feelings, why can't I? We're made in God's image. God thinks, we think. God loves, we love. God feels, we feel. Our feelings are manifested even when we don't recognize them. When our feelings are hurt, many times we react with sadness or tears. When we're fearful, our breathing changes. Our hearts beat faster. Our muscles tense. We need to pay attention to our feelings. Ignoring anger, sadness, and fear are symptoms of spiritual unhealthy, emotionally unhealthy spirituality. In the book, the author points out that many times Christians use that we view anger and fear as sin. How do we get past that belief? We know God feels, so we can have assurance from him that these feelings are a part of who we are in Christ. Philippians 4:6-7, don't be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and mind in Christ Jesus. God sees our emotion and enjoy it. God sees our emotions of enjoyment and healthy desires and recognizes destructive behaviors that can harm us. Continuing in chapter 1, the author writes, we need to look back to move forward. Without doing this exercise, he says we can have emotional immature. Pastor Julius on Sunday said we all have invisible scripts. Our families can place unintentional roadblocks in our spiritual lives. As I was raised by my mother and my grandmother, I was lacking the influence of a father figure. This caused emotional immaturity in me. My growth would stop and start like an old car that needed a tune-up. My faith was unstable. Yet God was faithful. He guided me by placing people in my life. He showed me his love. Now, looking back to move forward is a wonderful memory for me. I can look back and see what God has done in my life. He protected me in life-threatening situations. He gave me direction through the Holy Spirit on decisions I made. And he put brothers and sisters in Christ around me. Ask yourself this question. What am I beginning to know about myself? Are these roadblocks keeping me from knowing myself and God? We have to make a U-turn, as I did, to figure out how to remove those roadblocks that were holding me back. Again, I found that I can really know how he is moving in my life by what he has done in my life and what he says he will do. God wants us to experience more than we can imagine. Let us give the Holy Spirit more room in our hearts. Since I'm a slow learner, God has to repeat himself in his word. Jeremiah 29:13, and again in James 4:8, God says, he promises to draw close to me when I draw close to him. I paraphrase there. But what more could I ask for? For God to draw close to me. Let us pray. Oh God, help me to know you, to trust you, with your heart, with your help, open my heart to to see clearly. You have given me a feelings to know you better. You have given me healing in my spiritual journey from my past. Lead me, help me to follow, and to be sensitive to your voice through your word. In Christ, amen. One more thing. Don't trust your feelings. Trust the God who created you.
Take just a moment to worship God with our offering. If you're joining us online or you'd like to give electronically, you can do that on our website. Or if you'd like to give an offering in person, please wait till the service is over and you can deposit that in the collection plate on your way out. Stand and join with me in confessing our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We pray. Lord God, we thank you that you allow us to know you by your word and by the actions of your word made flesh, your Son, Jesus Christ, his death and resurrection for our resurrection, that we might be made new in the image of Christ, a new creation, righteous and holy in your sight because of him. We pray that we might live up to our new identity, that our feelings would match your feelings, Lord, that we were made in your image. We pray that our hearts would be knit to yours, and remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Receive the blessing of our Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace. Amen. And we sing our closing hymn.
I don't know about you, but I feel pretty close to God during times of worship and meditation. When I shout out all the things that are going on in my life and take a few moments, sometimes more than a few moments, because sometimes when you enter into a place of worship and meditation, it's just so nice and so sweet you don't want to live that kind of a situation. So I pray that as we sing this song, that talks about blessing the Lord, our souls. See, David was able to talk to himself and say, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. that you gotta talk to yourself and tell your inner self to bless the Lord. Amen. Let's do that this morning.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul. Worship His holy name.
See, the sun comes up.
God bless you. Thank you so much for coming tonight.